Hey everyone, Lauren here from Dominion Lending Center's Expert Financial. Today we are going to talk about some new and a bit confusing changes to some mortgage rules in Canada. And for all you buyers that thought, oh, things are looking up, rates are coming down, they're changing some policies, well, you're about to get the rug pulled out from underneath you. So recently there's been a lot of talk from both the government and financial regulator, OFSI. OFSI is the Office of Superintendent of Financial Institutions, okay, just to put that out there, about how they're trying to make housing more affordable and sustainable. But here's the twist. The two sides seem to be sending mixed signals on how they're actually going to achieve this. So first up, let's look at what the government's recently introduced. They've announced plans to help Canadians buy their first home by allowing 30-year amortization periods on insured mortgages for first-time home buyers. Okay, 30-year amortizations of his new builds. Okay, if you're putting less than a 20% down payment, and plus they raised the maximum amount for insured mortgages from $1 million to $1.5 million. Okay. The idea here is to make monthly payments more manageable, expand options, and so more Canadians can afford homes. Okay, so this sounds good, right? Okay, but here's where it gets complicated. OFSI, the Office of Superintendent of Financial Institutions, has introduced new rules that can actually make it harder for some buyers to get a mortgage. OSFI's changes are focused on reducing financial risk for banks, which include limiting high debt to income loans and tightening the stress test so that borrowers have to qualify for their mortgage as if the rates were higher. So on one side, the government's encouraging first-time home buyers and buyers to get out there, extending loan terms and raising insured mortgage limits. But OFSI's saying, wait a minute, let's make sure that people aren't borrowing too much compared to their income, and this could limit what you're approved for, potentially lower the amount you can borrow. In fact, OFSI's saying or stating that the mortgage amount should never exceed more than 4.5 times your income. So what's the result? So while the government's moves might seem like they're making it easier for to buy a home, OFSI's restrictions could actually reduce your buying power. For many potential buyers, these stricter rules mean they might only qualify for a lower loan amount and need to look for more affordable properties, if they're even out there. Now, what are the alternatives? So some buyers may now have to look for more alternative lenders that aren't governed by OFSI's rules, but keep in mind these options usually come at higher interest rates, which means increased monthly payments. All right, so what's the takeaway here? We have two different approaches at play here. The government, the ones that increase affordability, while OSFI is focused on making sure both the lenders and borrowers are financially stable. For buyers, this can mean some trade-offs when it comes to qualifying for the mortgage you want. So what's the takeaway? We have two different approaches here, all right? The government saying, okay, we're gonna try and make things more affordable and work with CMHC and everything else. But OFSI says, we don't care about your affordability. We're here to protect the financial institutions and to protect our buyers and our homeowners from being over leveraged, right? So they're gonna be focusing on making sure the borrowers and the financial institutions are more stable. So for buyers, this can mean some trade-offs when it comes to qualifying for the mortgage you want. It makes me wonder if OFSI and the other government officials have ever been in the same room together. This is crazy. Anyway, thanks for watching. As these changes come into effect, it's more important than ever to work with a knowledgeable mortgage broker, help you navigate these updates, and find out what works best for you and within your budget. So make sure you like, subscribe, more insights. Love to hear what you think about these upcoming changes. Nobody's really talking about them, but I just wait. It's coming. Anyway, thanks for listening. Hope to see you in the next video.